So today I'm going to show you how to make a spray skirt for a canoe. I think that it's pretty much just as important as a haul or a paddle on a long expedition because it keeps water out, keeps your stuff dry, keeps the wind out primarily, it's a big one, and helps keep you warm when it gets cold. So I'm going to walk you through the steps, and hopefully it is some use for you as you go ahead and make your own spray skirt. This will be about the sixth or seventh one that I've done, and every time I do it, it gets a little bit better. So the first step that we're going to do is we're going to apply a strip of Velcro. We're going to put the loops on the boat. We're going to keep the hooks on the skirt so the edge of the skirt's a little bit more stiff and easier to put on. I've used epoxy in the past, but this time I'm using self-adhesive Velcro onto the boat because that was suggested to me to try. And I don't know if it's going to work as well as epoxying Velcro on, but we'll try it out and see if that works. Made sure that the edge of the boat was really clean before we started. So that way the adhesive sticks to the boat and not to any of the dirt. This is a little bit tedious. We'll come back when we finish wrapping all the way around. Okay, so we've put the Velcro on all the way around the boat, all the way from about a stern one piece. We started at the stern, went to the bow, and then went back to the stern. We've gone with 1 inch this time. I've used 2 inches in the past, but that always seemed like overkill. So we've cut down to 1 inch. And so now we're gonna get out our actual skirt material, which we're using 1.9 ounce silicone impregnated ripstop nylon to cover the boat. And we'll show you how you actually make a custom cover. Okay, so I've started by draping my nylon, my material, over the bow of the boat, just rolled up. And I've got the bow all lined up such that the ends of the fabric are here. And what I'm just gonna do is I'm just gonna sew these two pieces together down here, sew it a couple times. You don't have to be fancy, you don't have to be good at sewing, I'm not. I'm just gonna sew it right down here and we're gonna use that to pull against as we stretch the fabric tight against the front of the boat. Okay, so now we've sewn this up and we've got a nice seam there and we're gonna turn this inside out once we're done. So this, of course, is not going to show. We'll trim it up. So now all we're going to do is we're going to take this material and we're just going to roll it off down the boat. All right, so we've got our fabric all laid out across. We've got our seam that's been sewn at the bow, and we're going to walk our way back to the stern. And this is where we're going to set the tension for the whole spray skirt by picking how tight we pull it here. And we have a little bit of an obstacle to work with because we have a rudder mount, which means that we only are going to be able to sew right here because it needs to be open here for the rudder and rudder cables and that type of stuff. So as we pull this back, we're gonna pick how tight we want it. And I'm gonna have to set the camera down in order to do that, but I'm gonna draw a marker with a Sharpie right where I wanna sew. And then I'll show you once I've got that done. Okay, so I've drawn these two marks right at the end of the boat. I'm just gonna sew between here and I'm gonna cut off the rest of the fabric. All right, so I've sewn right along that mark. It's nice and tight. If we look at the boat overall, it's nice and tight. And so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut this off, hem this edge, make this kind of all nice, and then we'll go from there. All right, so this end is now, it's not finished, but it's done for our point in time. It's gonna get turned inside out. We can finish it off later, but now it's time to start actually cutting the sides. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna put weights, hang weights from the edge to make it tight side to side. If you notice, there's still a little bit of sag here. We wanna get all that sag out. So we're gonna hang weights side to side on it. And then once we've hung those weights on there and it's all nice and tight, I'm gonna take a Sharpie and draw a line right underneath where that Velcro is. And right underneath where that Velcro is, that's where I'm gonna sew on the hooks. And the hook Velcro will be there. And then after we've got that sewed on, I'm gonna cut this off and we should have the actual body of our skirt completed at that point in time. Alrighty, so we've got our weights hanging down And they've got them periodically along the sides of the boat. And what they're doing is they're nice and they're holding the top really tight. And so I'm gonna draw right along on the side right underneath where that Velcro was. And we're gonna start right back here where the Velcro starts. Start it right here. And it's really easy to do. Draw, and it's okay if you make a couple mistakes because this is of course gonna be on the inside and this is all gonna be covered up with the Velcro anyway. And so we're just gonna take this, we're gonna go all the way around. All right, so I've drawn the line all the way along. Really simple, just dragging the Sharpie underneath where the Velcro is. Now I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna now sew my hooks. Remember I sewed the loops, or stuck the loops onto the boat. I'm now gonna sew the hooks of the Velcro right here. And I'm gonna put it on this side so that way we're gonna be able to flip it inside out once we're done with that. So that's gonna take a while to sew that on, but I'm gonna sew first one right here, then the other one, and then after I'm done that, we'll put it on, then we can trim off the excess and make that all nice. All right, so I'm just sewing. We're going really slow because the machine doesn't really like the Velcro. And we're just gonna go all the way around. We've got one side done. We've got just one of the seams made, and we'll do all the way around. Then I'll go through and I'll put the seam on the other side of the Velcro strip. All right, so after a couple hours and one trip to get the sewing machine fixed, I've got one set of stitches along the edge of the Velcro. And what I'm going to do is we're now going to test it, lay it out and see if everything's tight before I put the other one down, because if we have to rip out the seam, we don't want to have to rip out twice. So I'm gonna put it on. We're gonna put it on the front and the back, and then we're gonna stretch it over the sides and we'll see if we can get a little bit of an image of how that works. Okay, so I stretched the cover over both ends and now I'm gonna pull it to the side. And as I pull it to the side, I'm gonna start at the front. I'm just gonna tack down that. I'm gonna come over here and we're just gonna work our way back, pulling it as we go, and we're just gonna see if it ends up, you know, nice and taut at the end. Okay, so we've pulled it over the side and it ended up being pretty tight. It's not perfect, but it's pretty darn tight. And that'll actually tighten out a whole lot more as we're able to put that second seam and prevent this for a little bit of sag from happening there. But it works well. There's not a lot of ripples in it. It's pretty tight, and so I think it's gonna be good for tonight. And tomorrow we'll sew the rest of the sides on and start cutting out the the cockpits. All right, so we finished sewing the Velcro onto the sides and it came out pretty well. There's no wrinkles along the top. It's tight as a drum as you go back. You don't see any problems. I did leave a little bit of extra here at the stern because you've got to deal with rudder cables and things. So I didn't make that too tight. And that should only really be a problem keeping water out if we're like lowering the boat into the water and the stern goes underwater or something like that. But that shouldn't even leak too much, and with the auto bailer, it shouldn't be a problem. But we've gone through, we've sewed it all up, all along the side, two seams, and it's in pretty good shape. So now we're gonna mark where all the seats should go. We're gonna cut off the edges, and we're gonna seal those. We're gonna use a lighter. Normally I'd like to use a soldering iron. Just go, makes a nice cut and fuses it all at once, but I left my soldering iron in Michigan, and so I'm just gonna cut it and then do it the slow way with a lighter, and we'll cut out the seat holes, and I'll show you how we pick where to put the seat holes in just a little bit. So the first thing we're going to draw in is the hole we're going to cut for the coffin, which is the compartment where we sleep. And so this is not something we would normally do in making a spray skirt. But the other three holes will be. And so we're gonna cut the spot from just inside of this thwart, because the Velcro is gonna go right along the thwart to right along this thwart. So I'm gonna give it maybe 4 inches, and I'm just gonna draw a line right across, and then we'll cut. Then I'll leave maybe a 3 inch or 4 inch gap here. I'll get a 4 inch gap. I'm just gonna draw, and this is gonna be freehand. We're gonna draw right along here, and we'll show you how I'm gonna do this. So I'm gonna hold here, and I'm just going to draw, and that line is pretty straight. And now I'm gonna hold my thumb right at the edge of the boat. That's not a bad line either. And we'll go all the way around. So we're now gonna seal or fuse the edge to prevent it from fraying, and you have to be really careful with this because it's really easy to light the material on fire and then everything's all ruined. You have to start over again and order more material, and you don't wanna do that. So take it really slow, use your lighter, and just barely tap the edge until those frayed bits start to retreat just a little bit. Okay, so I finished sealing the edge, and now we're gonna cut out the cockpit seats. And to do that, you have to use a light. So you put a light underneath the seat, shining it up so you can see where the seat is. And you mark the points, the sides of the seat, behind the seat, and then up where the knees should go. And you just do that by feel, and then you just connect the dots with the Sharpie to draw the circle, and you cut that out just like you cut out the hole for the coffin. Okay, so we've cut out all of the cockpits. I made it larger than I did in previous boats because we do have sliding seats, and I do want to be able to exploit that as our need to trim the boat differently will change as we have 3 or 4 paddlers based on if someone's sleeping. We also have the side-to-side seats. We need to make it pretty wide. We are now at a point where you do have to make a decision about how you want to cut your actual skirts to come up and cinch across your chest. And the big thing is, do you want to make it a perfect cylinder where you just sew it up, you know, 24 inches all around or whatever? And the advantage of that would be that you can then tie it back and you can have an open compartment. Or do you want to make it fitting where it's shorter in the back and then longer in the front, so that way when you are needing it, when it is raining, everything rolls off of you. And based on the time of year that we're gonna go with having just a complete cylinder. It's also a little bit easier to sew, which will cause a little bit more water to pool inside of the skirt when it is raining. However, when it's not raining, it should make the ride a lot more comfortable and get better airflow inside the boat. What we're gonna do is I'm just gonna cut off pieces that are, you know, height. I think I'm probably gonna go with, you know, whatever, from, you know, 24 inches or so. And I'm just gonna sew around and put the seam on the inside so that way it pulls up, and I'm going to sew all the way around, and then we'll just sew right up the back, and we're going to do that on all three of them. We're going to leave off the sleeping compartment, and we're going to just do that one, take care of that one last. So we're going to do these three, and then we'll get back to it in a little bit. All right, so I'm just cutting off the side. I'm going to then go through and sear the whole edge and get it nice and fused. I'm going to go around and cut it off. I wasn't going to do that now, but I didn't get enough material to not use this. Okay, so I've now cut all of these pieces. They're all half a width wide and long enough to reach around. And so now I'm just going to sew them on. I'm going to sew it so that way the edge of the seam goes up and It might not look as nice as if the seam's tucked inside, but if it's sealed up, it'll push water away from the seam as opposed to having all the water drain into the seam. And I'd much rather stay a little bit dry and have that seam stick out. I might do French seam to make it look a little bit pretty, but that's really not necessary. So we're gonna do that and we'll come back in just a little bit. Okay, so I'm sewing the drawstrings into all the skirts now, and I'm putting them in before I sew, and sewing them in because it's a pain in the butt to sew in the hem and then try to feed it through. So we just do that as we go, and then once you finish the hem, it's already done and ready to put the toggle on. So we've sewn all the skirts on. I just went around and then sewed a seam up, and I put little toggles on, and it's worked pretty well. The seams look pretty nice, and you know, when you climb in, you have a seat. It seems like it's really big, but it needs to be really big because the seats slide forward and back, and so you need a little bit more room. And particularly this front seat, because Colin will sit pretty far forward probably, because the sleeper will move weight back. But when it rains, you can pull this in and, you know, once we seal this with the silicone, that should keep the water pretty well out with a raincoat over this part. So I feel like it. Okay, so we're now going to sew in the coffin. And I'm not really going to go into much detail as to how to do that because I think that's not really much use for many people, unless you're doing something like we're doing, in which case you can talk to me about it. But the big idea is that the sleeping compartment has to open on its own if the boat capsizes. So it can't be sealed all the way around, so we're just going to seal it one seam along the back, a really thin strip of Velcro on the front, and then we're going to hang weights on it from the side. And so I've just made a mark right where I want the back of it to go, right behind the edge. And I'm just gonna put two rows of stitches in, and then I'm gonna sew in Velcro at the other end, and that should be good. Then I'll just attach some weights onto the side, and we'll get back with you after we get that done. So I was testing the seam sealer, which is just 50% silicone, 50% mineral spirits, and you just mix it together, and then you paint it on whatever you wanna seal. And the mineral spirits gets the silicone thin enough to fit into the holes in your cloth. Otherwise, it just kind of comes in clumps on the outside and doesn't really seal anything. So about an hour ago, I sealed this, which is just a bag I made out of the ripstop nylon. And I let it dry for an hour and filled it up with water. And it's holding pretty well. So I think that seal works well enough. And we're going to use that on our boat. Okay, so we're now going to seam seal the boat, and to do that we're using silicone, clear 100% silicone, GE, and we're using odorless mineral spirits. We're mixing them together one-to-one, and I'm just stirring them up inside of a little bucket with a paintbrush, and I don't know if you can see it. Let's see if I can get down there so you can kind of see the consistency we're dealing with. It's pretty viscous, and so all we've done is essentially just diluted the, or thinned, rather, the silicone. So now it should paint on really, really easily. And we're just going to go do nice, easy strips. And we're going to try to avoid dripping any of this stuff in places we don't want it. So I'm just going to take a very small amount on the brush, and I'm just going to run it gently along the seam. And that should make that seal completely waterproof. I'll go do that in the next one too. And it's going to stay this color. It's going to stay shiny, so it's not going to be the prettiest thing ever. However, I'll take a little bit in the away in the aesthetics department in order to not have water drip on me while I'm sleeping again like we did last time. All right, so here we are. We've run a layer of that all the way around all of the seams on the boat, and we're now going to let it dry overnight, and we'll come and we'll finish the skirt tomorrow. Hi everybody, the silicone is now dried and the skirt is complete, and it's a good thing too because we're just a couple days away from leaving on the Mississippi River Challenge, and so in about a week we're going to be on the water, and I hope that as you follow along and build your own skirt, you'll be on the water soon too.